Okay, our little Webster record player. And we're going to give it our trial run here and see if it works. It should work, hopefully. Okay, here's the manual reject button is right here. Cool, and there it is. Oops, let's turn some sound on here. I didn't put the jack in. That's nice. Nice. This one here is just an attachment. It does not have its own amplifier. I have it playing through the little MP3 amp that I have back there. Anyway, let's take a look at this thing in slow-mo. By the way, the adjustment screws, there's only two on here. This front one is the height during the change cycle of the tone arm, and the second one back is the landing adjustment. There is no trip out adjustment. You don't have trip out adjustments with velocity trip. If you try to move the arm by hand into a different part of the record, you'll find that it will reject before it gets to the end. But if you let it play the whole way through, it'll play through to the end and it works fine. That's because it relies on the speed of the trip arm back here. This trip arm right down there, it relies on the speed of that to engage the lobe on the bottom of the turntable to start trip. One other thing on this thing, these sharp-eared people that have super good hearing, you're going to notice it's a very slight tremolo to it. There's a reason for that. If you look at the drive wheel, the metal of the drive wheel is bent. And there's nothing I can do to straighten that out. You can see it's just slightly, you'll get a slight tiny bit of tremolo, but nothing to worry about. But it's just, that's the way it is, and that's the way it will be. I can't straighten it without risking breaking it. And with an irreplaceable item, I'm not going to take that chance. So anyway, let's look at this thing without power, because it changes so fast, it's hard to see. So now we reject it here with a manual reject button like that. I want to watch what happens. Now, you watch the fingers. The arm is lifting up. Let's go and put my hand over on the other side here. The arm is lifting up like that. Yep. And then you see the fingers are collapsing inwards. And the little rubber donut is expanding. That's our handmade donut, which isn't perfect. It's not perfect, but it's as good as it's going to be. And the set down there, and then it releases the cam from the bottom of the turntable. That was a click you heard, and then it plays until the velocity trip hits the cam when it gets to the end of the record. And as I said, it requires the speed of the thing going. If it goes slowly, like it would normally go through the grooves of a record, it won't reject. But when it goes quicker at the end, that's when it forces the little lever on the velocity trip into the cam to start the cycle. And that's it. That finishes the record changer, the little Webster. And now it's just putting it back into the cabinet and redoing the wiring, which is nothing really. But it's done.